days. Now, Dr. Omar needs your help. She only got a few subscribers. She need 1,000 subscribers now. You guys can do it, this one. I think she got 98 subscribers. Come on now. Hit like, share, subscribe. Hit like, share, subscribe. Come on now. You can do it. You can help Dr. Omar subscribe. But anyhow, we finna go back to our grave. But don't forget us. This is your Aunt Linda who died on the Titanic. Man, they gave us no lifeline. No lifeline for us. We died on the Titanic. Come on now. Hit like and subscribe.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the home of Black Titanic. You guys, this is about the board meeting. This is about Tisha and my soul. Look, let's start off with Martell walking into, well, it started off, the first two people there was Kimmy and Maurice, right? And they walks in the room and they says, well, where is everybody? And then Kimmy said, this is Tisha. Yeah, this is Tisha's event, but she's late for her own event. Next, walk in Martell. Now, y'all, when Martell walks in, that suit coat he got on is so little to that button is about to pop off. But Maurice, Martell, and what's her name? Kimmy act like she be smitten when she see Martell. Her eyes just, melt like butter when she see Martell. Y'all ever notice that? And if you ever ask her about anything about Martell, whenever she say anything about Martell, it's so adorable. Oh, he's a good man. Oh, yes, he's a good mom. He's a good man. He also is a great dad. Yeah. All right, you guys. Let's listen. Here they come. They're walking into building 600.
That's kind of usual. Why did you get this at the head of the table?
It's the middle.
It's not. This is Tisha's meeting.
I would have figured Tisha would be here. What's up, Marty?
Marcel and Tisha have invited the original six of the comeback group to pitch a new idea.
What could go wrong?
Well, they're late.
That part. If that's the only thing that goes wrong, then it'll be a success.
I'm excited that she even brings us together.
I'm excited that everybody said okay.
Mm-hmm. Everybody?
Yes.
No, hold on. What's going on now?
Don't be jumping on chairs around.
So, right here, when he says, is everybody coming? He moves his chair over. He act like he was shocked. And then this great big old smile came on this man's face, y'all. He's going to get to see his book. He haven't seen her in a while, so he's going to get to see his boo. He was just kidding now. He was just kidding with Kimmy because he moved the seat right on back over there by Kimmy. Yes, he's waiting on his boo to walk through that door. Now, let me tell y'all something. How are you going to be an event planner, and you're not there? You're not there to even greet the people that you invited. Nobody is in the room when Kimmy and Maurice come through that door. Not nobody. And that's why she said this is Tisha's event. Man, not very professional. That's the number one thing you got to learn in business. Be on time. You got to be on time when somebody else gets it. But when you give it, you got to be a lot earlier than everybody else. make sure everything is set up in the room, in the boardroom. But just teaching myself, buddy. Unprofessional. So Tisha and Marceau is still late. If I'm going to be one of your sponsors, if I'm going to pour into this business, I would be having a second thought because that is very unprofessional. Now, mail walks through the door. Still no Tisha and no Marceau. They are still late for their own event. But Martell is staring at Melody. He's just drooling after her. He's just looking at her, you know, like as if, you know, he want to eat her up or something. But it's hard to figure this nonsense out. One minute he loves her, the next minute he at her throat. But as you guys know, we know they are. She says she's having the battle of her life because this man is sending her through hell and back, trying to get financial things from her, trying to block her, their daughter, Sugar Mama, products from coming out, trying to block the children from filming. Well, he has. But anyway, Mel walks through the door. Now notice Maurice, even Maurice staring at her. She looked very, very beautiful.
Excited that everybody said okay.
Mm-hmm. Everybody?
Yes.
Hold on.
Hey.
Hey, man. How's it going?
Yes, good. How are you?
What's up,
hey.
Girl?
Hey.
Aren't you
beautiful?
Girl, I'm rushing. What's up?
How are you feeling?
I'm good.
Okay. I like this.
Coming here today with the Core 6 meeting, I'm in a good space. Even though Mel and I, we have our challenges dealing with the courts and personally, I'm going to keep this meeting professional out of respect of Patricia and Marceau. I'm just hoping that we can make it through this meeting without any tension or anything of that nature.
We'll do a couple of...
Yeah, Marceau and Tisha don't even respect their own event, their own meeting. Everybody's sitting there waiting for them. Very unprofessional. Yeah, very unprofessional. So Tisha and Marceau finally arrived. They walked through the door. Tisha got that little fake smile. The first thing I noticed is that she got male hairstyle. Yes, once again, she got male hairstyle, and she get lighter and lighter every season. But can you trust your coworkers? Can you trust your coworker? Especially Marceau. You know, they got a history of hustling and scamming and scheming. Can you trust these two people? They're walking in here trying to convince you to be their coworker, trying to convince you to pour into them. One of the major mistakes that they're made already is coming in late. You know, Mel is a very professional businesswoman, so she noticed all of that. Now we got Martell sitting at the table. We got Martell, you know, he's been into the real estate business. But instead of Martell to act very professional, Martell is acting like the class clown. I did not like that about him. I felt like here was his time to show us, you know, his professional side when it came to real estate business and the business world. You had Kimmy. Kimmy was very professional, but Kimmy is not, her profession is not real estate. Her profession is registered nursing. She probably could run rings around everybody's throat when it comes to nursing. So that's her specialty. Now you got Maurice. You got Maurice the lawyer sitting at the table. Real estate is not his profession either. But who is the boss? You got the boss lady, Melody. Who is the professional? Already, Keisha have burnt her, you guys. Can you trust your coworker? Can you trust him? Can you trust Martell? Marceau? Yeah, Martell too. Talk about Marceau and Tisha mainly. Can I trust them? I guess that's what's going through Melody's mind. She probably already done sorted this out. The maliciousness that they have caused me. The harmful things that they have said about me and my children. Now you want me to work with you. Can you trust your coworker at work? Can you tell them your intimate, most details, disclose that to them? And then when they get mad at you, they tell all of your business. Right now, my soul now was walking through the door. Now, y'all need to consider this situation. That already, this girl have burnt mail. Already, there is probably zero trust. My soul and his wife, the hustling, scheming, and scamming, that's what they do. Now they finna come in the boardroom and think they finna hustle and scam and scheme against Mel. They think that they coming in there to sell her own ideas and make her pay for it.
I'm just hoping that we can make through this meeting without any tension or anything of that nature.
We're gonna do a couple of lunch and learns.
Yes, hi. Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
So right there, Tisha bent over and hugged Mel. You look pretty. Now look, fake smile.
Here we go.
Fake.
How are you?
Good. I like the energy. What's up? I'm good. How you doing? Good. After much preparation, today is the day we're going to present my idea for the Black Business Expo. Hopefully, we can convince everybody to come on board.
Even though it may seem like it may be something that would resemble a comeback group, it's not a comeback group. They need to remember that.
Right.
How's everybody?
Now, that's the first thing. Zero trust. Zero trust, girl. How can I trust you? My idea. Now, I'm sitting up there. Mel, talk about Mel. Even Kimmy, even Maurice, even Martell. All of y'all know that this girl sitting up there saying, this is my idea. This is the comeback group. This is Mel's idea along with her husband when she was married to him. This was their plan. They bought the comeback group together. They were the one had the money and the funds and everything. Can I trust you? No. Already, I can't trust you. Because you coming in there talking about something. This is my idea. What are you really bringing to the table? You saying that this is your idea. Everybody in that room know this is not your idea, you and this man, your husband. What are you bringing to the table? Right now, you sitting in front of a powerhouse, and that's Mel. Mel is the powerhouse. They're getting ready to do their presentation, the Black Expo.
We are so enthused about today's.
I like that energy. Yes.
Black.
You look good.
What?
You
want to
make a date afterwards? Yeah. What are you going after?
Honey, it's just all happy.
It's all happy. Word on the street and also in social media, Mel got a new boo.
Baby, that's why I'm sensing attention in the air.
Martell's just trying to get some attention because Mel.
You see that? You see that? Mel got a new boo. That's another reason why you can't trust her, because she gossip. Yeah, she gossip. She's trying to tell everybody that this woman is dating around. That's what she's trying to tell everybody. She is gossiping. We said, leave Mel out of this. Mel shouldn't be your storyline and your confession. And then you give this little shade, these backhanded compliments. Like nobody can catch her. Oh, but she look cute. Yeah, here she go. Yeah, Mel, word on the street that she got a boyfriend. That backhand compliment. Gossiping. See, can I trust you? That's one of the things I want to know about my co-worker. If you know anything about my business, can I trust you? She telling the whole world that this woman got a boyfriend, and you know, and then it's just backhanded, but at least she look cute. Let's keep it going.
Looking good.
But you were just in it.
Ha ha.
Let's go, I'm ready.
So, the Black Business Expo combines numerous entrepreneurs, leaders in various fields under one roof to share their knowledge in creating, maintaining, and growing businesses in their respective industries. So we would like for you guys to participate in a panel or presentation highlighting your business, because we have a variety of different businesses that we do. Scott Realty, we have Sculpt, we have Affinity Properties, and we also have Black.
One thing we will say that, you know, part of it was like, don't call it a comeback, because our comeback, we do a lot of brainstorming and probably more storm than brain.
What you making?
That's not y'all business.
Guys, I'm done. I'm leaving.
No,
you can't just say I. Me. It's about us. I'm not your
sweetheart.
Yes, I can. Everything you're saying is a lie. But you can defend yourself. I don't care.
I got to defend myself for who? For what?
Nothing.
You ain't doing nothing. Ain't nothing. Nothing. So what do I?
Y'all remember that part right there where they sitting at the table and they talking about I, me. When in reality, they wouldn't put their name on the track. They wanted a hoax to put up everything, all the collateral, all the resources. They had already did it now. And then they bought up what's her name? Kimmy and Tisha had some kind of company that went well for damn. It was just on paper, but it had not been successful. It had not been recognized. It's just something they had on paperwork. And they tell me, I, me. That I and that me is telling you guys that I'm not going to be no fool.
Why where we're at right now is because we never handle business.
Well, our recommendation is going to be, and that we're going to stick hard on, is a dissolvement of the comeback group.
Yes.
So she dissolved that, right? So they just coming back now with a new name, Black Expo. A new name, but it's the same thing. Same idea. All of Mel's brain, her storming, her brainstorming, her proposer, her everything that she had worked for and put together. Now they done stole it and standing up there now. These are hustlers. What do they bring to the table? They're bringing nothing to the table but trying to sell you back your own ideal and expect for you to pay for it.
But right now, we're just saying, hey, this is the initiative we're going to do, and kind of just assemble the coalition of the women.
Silence in the room.
Good job, guys.
Thank you. That deserves a
toast. So, Martell over there, like he's the class clown.
I think the presentation went really well, and I'm hoping that everybody would be on board. I mean, looking around the room, it seems like I got everyone's attention.
This is the comeback group, so although things seem like they went well, you know, we have the ability to snatch defeat out of the jaws of victory.
So even my soul said this is the comeback group. Even my soul, he don't know what he's saying, but he telling on himself that we just ball back in the comeback group. Everything, her Mel's ideal, Mel proposal, Mel's everything. He just said it himself. Hustlers, scheming and scamming, always hustling people. These two right here remind me of two donkeys. Donkey number one and donkey number two. Husband and wife team. Stay tuned. It gets better. So now teachers is through with her presentation. They up there talking about all their businesses that they're running. And she goes back to the table and she sit down now. but she's a fake friend and Mel knows it. No, you're not fooling Mel. You're not even. And what did Kimmy say? If you wasn't my relative, I wouldn't fool with you. So it's dangerous to have a fake friend in your company, or to pretend that they're your friends because they work with you. They like to abuse you. They like to step on your head. See, she trying to step all over Mel's head. She thinks she's pulling a wool over Mel's head. She said, this is my vision. This is my vision. She trying to step all over her head, trying to play games with Mel's head, but she's not smart enough. This is my vision, she gonna tell Mel. Malicious that she is. She's fake. Both of them is fake. They so malicious. They'll do anything to get ahead. Right now, they are backstabbing Mel. They are backstabbing Martell, but he ain't got sense enough to know it. They trying to take over you guys' idea. All right, let's just go. Let's just keep going. Let's just keep going. The backstabber, the hustler, the scamming, they scheming. This is my vision, she said. I had a vision. Already she backstabbing Mel. Already she trying to abuse her power. Like, this is my power, not yours. This is not your power. This is my power. I invented this, says Tisha and Marceau.
So although things seem like they went well, you know, we have the ability to snatch defeat out of the jaws of victory.
So what do y'all think about, like, the name? Y'all like the Black Business Expo?
For me, it depends on what is the objective of the event. Is it your event and we're just kind of showing up to participate?
She feel well, like a donkey.
And I wanted to present it to you guys.
Tisha's talking about her vision, but all I hear is Tisha and Marceau repurposing the comeback group and trying to sell it back to us.
What did
the
I tell
actual
y'all?
Comeback group. I'm saying it's like the idea is neither new or original.
What did I tell y'all? Backstabbing my soul and teacher scheming on these people. Now they done got together, call themselves to put their heads together. Them two right there. You see, look, we gonna make them do all the work for free. And then we got this foundation that they, people can donate to. Oh, y'all think I done do that? They can put their money on the foundation that they got. Yeah, they can sponsor our foundation. All the money go to them. All the money goes to them, but they do all the free work. Fake friends. They're overly exerting themselves into the project and trying to take credit. They overly exert themselves, you know, trying to be friendly with Mel, knowing that that's fake. Why? Because they need her. They need her, but they want to take all the credit for this girl's work. They want to take all the credit. Yeah. Backhand compliment. Oh, Mel, you look so nice. But Mel got a boyfriend. Yeah. Try to be nice as they can to this girl because they need a favor from her. Can y'all stand alone? No, that's what Timmy was saying. You're not standing alone. Standing alone means can you create on your own? Y'all think they think that people are stupid. Oh Lord, these people. Donkey number one and donkey number two. Let me take it back. Come on.
Well, the vision came to me and I wanted to present it to you guys.
Tisha's talking about her vision, but all I hear is Tisha and Marceau repurposing the comeback group and trying to sell it back to us. The actual comeback group. I'm saying it's like the idea is neither new or original. Is it? Because that...
So now we're down to the nitty gritty. She have exposed herself because her sister lost it. Well, it's just that picture of you and your husband. That just look like it's for y'all. Is this a group thing or is this just for you and her? And let me tell y'all something. Mel come in and she's going to come in now. Because Keisha and them is doing what they always do, trying to scheme on somebody, you guys. It's fake. She's a fake friend to this woman. She's fake. She need her input on a project when they fake friends and trying to be friendly with you. Or they need extra help in understanding what the real estate world is. Or they need help with getting a task done. They need this girl. Or they need her resources and her connection.
First of all, I think it's amazing. I think it's great. I like the name. I think y'all should stick with that. What's y'all's budget for your speakers and your panel?
What do you mean by the budget for the speakers and panels?
Like for your, the fee. You know, the fee.
Oh, paying you guys to speak.
What is your budget? Budget. At this moment, Keisha is feeling like the donkey that she really is. What is your duck? What is your budget? And then Kimmy chime in and Kimmy says, oh, well, yeah, are we going to be a part of this? Because it just looked like it's just you and him up there. That's who you got. Are we just to come in and just participate? In other words, are we just to come in and make money for you guys while y'all reap all the money and we do all the work? Yeah. Both of them looking like donkeys sitting up there. What is your budget? I know Keisha could have just got up and walked away. I know she felt like burying her head between her legs because she was so dumbfounded. So what is your budget? It's how Keisha looked like a donkey. I know she wanted to just walk away, man. Just walk away. If she could.